us to the Father, he makes it abundantly clear that he's uniting us to one another in this work. We can't image forth God in the world if we're not one, because God is one. In fact, this is how the world knows that we're from God, and how the world sees God is in our oneness. And another passage from John. John uses a lot of this light and darkness language, so I got a lot from John this morning. This is from 1 John 4. We love because he first loved us. If anyone says, I love God, and hates his brother, he's a liar, for he who does not love his brother whom he has seen cannot love God whom he has not seen. And this commandment we have from him, whoever loves God must also love his brother. And going back to the one another's I mentioned earlier, so we could spend our time today kind of unpacking practically what it means for us to shine as lights in the world or to do good works in the world. And I mentioned the one another's. Depending on how you parse them out or define the one another's, about a third of them refer to unity. Be at peace with one another, from Mark 9. Be of the same mind with one another, from Romans 12. Bear with and forgive one another, from Colossians 3. And then another third of those refer to loving one another. Love one another, from John 13, 15, 17, Romans 13, and 1 Thessalonians 3. Through love, serve one another, from Galatians 5. Love one another with brotherly affection, from Romans 12. So the one another is a scripture. If we were to spend most of our time there, most of our time would be spent unpacking the ways in which we can be one with each other, love each other, bear with each other, forgive each other. So I had an illustration this morning that hit me as I was eating breakfast, and I shared it with Candace, and she wasn't sure that it would land. Then I shared it with Tom, and Tom told me to do it, so. Bear with me. I think it's helpful. So thinking about our unity and our oneness and the how that's essential to our call to carry on this vision of Jesus to make the Father known in the world. We can't make him known to the world if we're not one. So here's my illustration. This morning, I'm not a morning person, but I got up early and made a big, beautiful omelet. It was eggs, spinach, bright orange peppers, and it was fantastic. Now notice I said I made an omelet. I didn't say I made eggs and spinach and peppers, right? The omelet is one thing. The omelet is not the eggs and the peppers and the spinach. Okay, so a few weeks ago, I actually taught from in the Beatitudes where Jesus says, blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, and talked about how we at Soma are here in the kitchen making a feast of righteousness for each other, for our community. And Peter was eating breakfast with me, and he had a plain bagel. Now, I know there may be some of you who prefer the plain bagel, but of the two, which is the feast of righteousness, right? It's the omelet, and it's an omelet. It's not the eggs and the spinach and the peppers, right? So when I was sharing this with Tom, he shared this French cooking term with me, mise en place. Is that right? So mise en place is, if you've seen in a kitchen where people are prepping their food beforehand, prepping and measuring, they've got all the ingredients that they're going to use, and they're all in separate buckets, diced up and sliced up and whatever, ready to be used. That's mise en place. And I think, honestly, we've got a really special thing going on here at Soma Northwest. And we're still at the mise en place sort of phase of what we're doing here. And I want to encourage everybody to press into this, to really own this ministry of oneness and of unity as we move from mise en place, us all just individual ingredients, we move in together into one omelet. God's mission is that we would know him, and he sent Jesus to carry on that mission. Jesus then commissions us to carry it on to the world, to make the Father known to the world around us, and he does it out of his love for us. So I'm going to read a couple more passages from 1 John that are really helpful for this. On both sides, I'm sorry to lose track of the pages here. Okay, 1 John 3, by this we know love, that he laid down his life for us, and we ought to lay down our lives for the brothers. 1 John 4, beloved, let us love one another, for love is from God, and whoever loves has been born of God and knows God. Anyone who does not love does not know God, because God is love. In this, the love of God was made manifest among us, that God sent his only Son into the world that we might live through him. Then 1 John 1, this is the message we have heard from him and proclaim to you. In our mission, this is the message we have heard from him and proclaim to you, that God is light, and in him is no darkness at all. If we say we have fellowship with him while we walk in the darkness, we lie and do not practice the truth. But if we walk in the light, as he is in the light, we have fellowship with one another. And the blood of Jesus, his Son, cleanses us from all sin. So God's desire is to make himself known so that we would see him and be drawn out of the darkness into his light and have fellowship with him and with one another. He sent Jesus to initiate that work, and he's commissioned us to carry it on. The essential way that we carry this work forward is by loving God and loving each other. So while we could have spent all of our time unpacking practically what that means, I want us to really get the essence of what it is we're doing. We're making the Father known to the world. We're primarily doing it by loving God and loving each other. I would say that MC might be a good context for unpacking more practically what that looks like. What does it look like for us to love one another, for us to be one omelet, as it were? So the essential way that we carry this word is to love God and one another. So we commit, and we can do that today, this morning, we can commit to pursuing the oneness that God died to purchase for us. Love each other, forgive each other, bear with each other, pursue each other, do life with each other, be one with each other. It's hard, and Satan opposes it, but it's God's will, and it is good. Amen. This is how the world sees the Father, us loving God and loving each other, being one with each other. The world sees God who is one.
Yeah.
So each week, we share a meal together to demonstrate our unity as one body. We remember what it cost God to bring us this unity. We call this meal communion. We share one bread, Jesus' body broken for us. One cup, Jesus' blood spilled for us. Remember our one Savior, Jesus Christ.